Yes, the tilting of Earth and its rotation around the sun is helping us to have different seasons, and at the same time sun rays are falling unequally on the different parts of the globe. It has created the tropical, subtropical and polar regions or temperate regions on the globe. The unequal distribution of sunlight has created variations in the temperature on different parts of the earth, and this different temperature is also responsible for different range of precipitation in different parts of the earth. The precipitation in the sense of both rainfall as well as snow. And this variation in the temperature and precipitation, that is rainfall and snow, has created different biomes, means cluster of organisms existing depending on a specific peculiar abiotic components. The abiotic components, that is light, temperature, soil, water, actually decides the type of biotic factor. Along with that, pathogens, parasites, and even the competitors also decides what type of organisms can exist in a given ecosystem, and the population of which organism is dominant in a given ecosystem, that is also decided by the predation, competition, and parasitism, like that, along with the abiotic factors. And these biomes, which you can see in the different parts of the world, is depending on the mean annual precipitation. It is a biome distribution with respect to annual temperature and precipitation. This graph it is. Biome refers to a cluster of organisms in a specific natural habitat. How these biomes are present, or the different biomes are dependent how they are on the temperature and precipitation, or the temperature and precipitation, how it creates different biomes. First one, this is you will see it is Arctic and Alpine. It is Arctic and Alpine tundra. Arctic and Alpine tundra. Can you see now? Here the precipitation means water, rainfall is 0 to 100 at the maximum, and temperature is always less than 0. Temperature is less than 0 means it is a snow covered area. Arctic and Alpine means peak of mountains like Himalaya and polar regions where it is always covered with the snow. Snow covered areas, where still you will see organisms there. Even in a snow laden areas also you will see, polar bears. You cannot see polar bear here. Yes or no? Thus, each and every temperate regions, temperature areas and its specific water content decides what type of organism should be present. And this again, each and every organism is adapted itself for its survival in a specific environmental conditions. Polar bear, it is having a capacity to dig the ice and get fishes from the bottom of the lake present there. That is Arctic and Alpine tundra, where the precipitation, that is actual rainfall, is not there, but the temperature is very less. That means it is a snow laden area. Next is coniferous forest. Coniferous forest. In this coniferous suchi prana kaadugalu antina andre ele udrisuva kaadugalu. Here temperature see, it starts from 0 almost. It reaches up to 15 degrees Celsius. Its temperature is low. In a temperate countries, Europe, America, temperate countries, temperature is low, and even the rainfall from 50 centimeter to 250 centimeter, 50 to 250 centimeter, rainfall is not too much also. There you will see coniferous forest. Coniferous forest. Next, you will see it is a desert. Desert. In the desert, you know, rainfall should be less. See, it is less than 50 centimeter is the annual rainfall. Varshaka 50 centimeter ashtu male beerudilla. Adarkinta kammi male beerutade. But temperature is too high nearly. That is mean temperature helta irudu ratri hagalella seri mean temperature that is nearly 23-24. It is nearly 50 degrees Celsius daytime irutade. Anta desert where annual precipitation or rainfall is less, scorching sunlight, but still you will see organisms like desert mongoose and you will see camel and variety of snakes you will see in the desert, along with the date palm like plants also you will see. Next you will see this is grassland. This is grassland. Grassland, African pine, like that grasslands where rainfall is not too much. It is 50 to 100, very less rainfall, and the temperature also varies to a great extent. Temperature that is near 0 to 25. Temperature variation is also very high, and the rainfall is less, where you will see grassland ecosystem. Only the grass you cannot see. The grass refers to animals. Remember, animal plant it is. In when the rain is there, rainy season is there, you can expect fully greenish grasses will be produced. But after once the water content is less in the soil, there is a death of these annual grasses, which becomes little dry as such. That is a grassland. Grassland biome you will see. When the annual rainfall is 50 to 100 and the temperature is near 0 to 25. That's the mean annual temperature. Next comes our tropical forest. Next comes tropical forest. This tropical forest, see, temperature is very high. Mean temperature itself is 20 to 25, very stagnant temperature. There is no, see, all this shows the fluctuations like this in the temperature, but here temperature is almost constant, 20 to 25 mean temperature. Rainfall it is 150 to 400 centimeter annual rainfall, annual precipitation. Too much of heavy rainfall. Adakke nitya haridvarna kaadugalu ante en heltaralla andre ಮಳೆ ಕಾಡುಗಳು ಅಂತ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಾನೇ ಮಳೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಸೋ ದಟ್ ಟಾಪ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೈಲಿ ಎನ್ರಿಚ್ಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರಾಪಿಕಲ್ ರೈನ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಟ್ರಾಪಿಕ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ 0 to 23 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆನ್ ದ ಗ್ಲೋಬ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ದಿಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರಾಪಿಕಲ್ ರೈನ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬಯೋಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಯು ಎನ್ ಐಡಿಯಾ ದಟ್ how this abiotic factor like water and temperature helps in distribution of organisms in different parts of the globe, and how they create different varieties of plants and thereby organisms. And next we will see how these organisms are adapted for this abiotic factors, or how this abiotic factors will decide what type of organism should be there and how those organisms are adapted for. For example, I told the polar bear, and if you see camel, like that different organisms which are existing in a specific biome, they are physiologically adapted and morphologically adapted for that specific climatic conditions. That is the temperature, water, light, and soil, how it decides the specific organisms in a given ecosystem, and how their population is changing, and the population concentration goes on changes. It depends on the survival of an organisms for a specific environment, how best it is adapted. that much best it can reproduce, its population increases and some other organism population decreases. Here the survival is nothing but the best and better adaptation of an organism for a specific given environment. That is how it is physiologically adapted and why it is flourishing. These two questions will be answered when we study, when we understand this abiotic factor's role in creating different biome. That we will see in the next class, that is temperature, soil, water and light. Abiotic factors in deciding how their decision role in organisms and population of a biome. Okay, thank you.